Hello, Vinyl Community. This is Randy, back today with another video. My friend Dale at Gatefold 33 has introduced a new thread. Actually, I think he probably started a week or so ago. A new thread for showing one record for every year that we've been alive. So he has, I think he's actually completed it now. He did it like in three segments. I'm going to have to break mine up into four segments because I have a few more years than him. So I guess the goal of this, though, was just to show one record for each year that you've been alive. And really, I think the only rule that he had for this was that you can't show the same artist twice. So yeah, at least a little bit of decision making and stuff. You know, you have to decide for some artists which record you want to use for that particular year. So these are not necessarily my favorite record for each year that I'm showing, but these are all like Dale said, each one of these I think is a great record. Each one is a fantastic record that I listen to and have listened to and plan to continue listening to. So yeah, so I was born in 1960, so I'm going to show you one record for each year from 1960, for this segment, 60 to 75. And like I said, there'll be three more segments after this. So the very first one, from 1960, I tell you, being born in 1960, you know, that was sort of that 60 to 64, the era before the, before the rock and roll. I guess you wouldn't say the rock and roll era started, but before, you know, really became dominant in the charts and everything. 60-64 is a little bit different. So my 1960 pick is Wonderland by Night by Burt Kampfert and his orchestra. That's what we're hearing right now. Fantastic record. Burt Kampfert was a German orchestra leader. I think he did some movie soundtracks. He had hit songs of his own, so Wonderland by Night was written by him. He has a trumpet player named Charlie Tabor. You can hear right there. And there's just a lot of great songs on here. Wonderland by Night is the big hit, though. Wonderland by Night, it's really weird. When I got this record, I got it at a Grimey's parking lot sale. They used to have parking lot sales where they would have a lot of dollar bins in the back. And I think you could get like 12 for 20, or maybe it was 20 for 12. Something like that. And this was one that I got. It's really in wonderful shape. And interesting thing, I was reading a book. I read a book shortly after I got this by Frank Conroy, I think is his name. I can't remember the name of the book. But this song, Wonderland by Night, was featured in that book very heavily. He talked about going to their prom, I guess. It must have been in 1960. And this was the song, the main song, I guess, at the prom. So it was a number one hit. Well, I think it's a great song. For 1961, I've got the sound of the Johnny Smith guitar. Johnny Smith is a guitarist from the 1950s, played some very mellow jazz. You can see that guitar there that he's holding. He had his own signature model guitar from Gibson, and really nice guitars. My understanding, those are extremely collectible guitars now, so... Yeah, this is a very mellow, instrumental guitar record. I'm a big Johnny Smith fan. I'm not going to show you all these records, all these labels and everything, but I figured I would show you some of the ones that maybe are a little bit unusual. So Royal Roost for this one. This came out in, 1961. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. It's the year they came out. For 1962, I have Gary Burton, new vibe man in town. Gary, I think, was extremely young when he started his professional career. I guess this must be what a vibraphone looks like when it's not put together. I've never seen that elsewhere. So, yeah. Excellent record on here. What's on here? Over the Rainbow, Like Someone in Love, You Stepped Out of a Dream. Wonderful record. 1963, I've got The Beatles, The The Beatles, Please Please Me. This is the first Beatles album, so yeah, this is one of those years where I had to choose. You know, do I want to go ahead and take the Beatles now, or is there something else from 63 that I decided to go ahead and go with Please Please Me? This is a fantastic album. I was just going to show you this label because it's a little bit different. It's a Parlophone label, but I've never seen these too often. Parlophone. Yeah, so the Beatles, Please Please Me. 1964. Johnny Rivers at the Whiskey A Go-Go. This is a fantastic album. This is a live album. He recorded it there at the Whiskey A Go-Go in Los Angeles. And it sounds live. You can really hear the people in the background and stuff, and some of it sounds like it's kind of artificial because they're so into the... you can hear them so clearly. So I don't know if that was some studio stuff I did. I mean, I can tell you I've been to the Whiskey A Go-Go, and it's an extremely small place, so I can just about feel like mainly this girl that you can hear screaming and stuff and yelling. She may have just been right there right at the front of the stage, and you may just be able to hear her that well. So, yeah, this is a fantastic album. I'm really going to show you this one because it's on Imperial Records. Don't see that label too often. Imperial Records. I think the Hollies were on that in the United States. 1965, Frank Sinatra. Frank Sinatra was still active right through the end of the 60s and into the early 70s. And I don't think I've shown this record before. Nice and Easy. So he sort of did these theme type albums. And the songs on here are all Nice and Easy. Nice and Easy is the first song. That Old Feeling, How Deep Is the Ocean, I've Got a Crush on You, Go to My Head, She's Funny That Way, Embraceable You. Frankie Boy, can't go wrong. 1966, The Mamas and the Papas. If you can believe your eyes and ears, the first Mamas and the Papas album has their two big hits on it, California Dreamin' and Monday Monday. But in addition to that, it has other, it's basically like, if you ask me, it's almost like a greatest hits itself. Straight Shooter, Got a Feeling, I Call Your Name, it was a Beatles song that they covered. Hey Girl, You Baby, In Crowd. There's the Mamas and the Papas. Yeah, their first album. Fantastic. The next band that I have is from 1967, The Turtles. This really worked out great that the Mamas and the Papas and the Turtles came out 2 years in a row, because these really are two of my favorite bands from the 1960s. I think of them both as vocal groups. I don't really put them in that same category as, you know, Beatles and Rolling Stones and, Grateful Dead and other rock bands. I think of these as vocal groups, mostly. Even though the Turtles played their own instruments, and they really were a real band, wrote a few of their own songs, but mostly did other people's songs. And so this is a greatest hits album, and so this has their two big hits on it, which were She'd Rather Be With Me and Happy Together. Some other great songs on here. You Baby, Outside Chance, Can I Get to Know You Better. Fantastic album. This was on White Whale. White Whale Records. Yep. Okay. 1968, one of my favorite bands, the Notorious Bird Brothers, The Birds. The Notorious Bird Brothers is the name of the album. They were down to three people by this time. David Crosby had been asked to leave the band. Of course, Gene Clark was gone by then. So this is, maybe this is my second favorite Birds. I like this one, and Dr. Birds and Mr. Hyde. Well, I really love all the Birds albums. I'd take any of them. I guess the big songs on here, though, are Going Back. Draft Warning is fantastic. Wasn't Born to Follow. Tribal Gathering. Wonderful album.
The Birds, Notorious Bird Brothers.
1969, The Ventures, Underground Fire. I was glad to be able to get a Ventures album in here because it's another one of my favorite bands. And, of course, they'd been around for a while by 1969. And on this album, it's really cool because the whole first side, they're doing their own original songs. Psychedelic type songs. And then on side two, they cover a bunch of psychedelic songs. So Born to Be Wild, Sunshine of Your Love, The Weight, Light My Fire, Down on Me, and Fire. So this is the best of both worlds. They've got their originals and they're doing covers. Classic Ventures instrumental songs. 1970, the Creedence Clearwater Revival. Creedence released Cosmos Factory. 1969, and this is another one. I mean, it's like a greatest hits album. Before You Accuse Me, Traveling Band, Looking Out My Back Door, Run Through the Jungle, Up Around the Bend, Who'll Stop the Rain, I Heard It Through the Grapevine, Long as I Can See the Light. That could be a greatest hits album right there. Most bands would be happy to have that many hit songs in their entire career. They've got it here on one album. Fantastic. This is actually an album that I did get back, probably when I was 10 or 11 years old. It was a Christmas gift, so a little bit worn, but still plays great. Let's see, we are up to 1971, Traffic, another one of my favorite bands, Low Spark of High Heeled Boys, probably my favorite Traffic album, you know, once again, like the Birds, I love everything they did. This is when they had their expanded group with a little bit more rhythm section. They had the guys from Muscle Shoals helping them out on this one. And so Low Spark of High Heeled Boys is probably the best song on here. But, you know, Light Up or Leave Me Alone, Many a Mile to Freedom, Hidden Treasure. The whole thing is fantastic. Yeah, I was just going to show you the inner sleeve on this one. How's this called? Inner sleeve. I have a reissue of this from a newer reissue from a few years ago, but it didn't come with this cool inner sleeve. 1972, Rolling Stones. Had to get the Stones in here, and I had to wait until, well, I mean, I could have chosen them for some other years, but 72, it's all Main Street. I was looking at this record on Discogs, this particular issue that I have, which is a 1994 remaster, and the only comment on Discogs is that this is the worst pressing of this record ever made. That's what the guy on Discogs said. So, you know, I guess I can sort of, it doesn't have any surface noise or anything, but it just doesn't sound real vibrant, real alive. And, but it sounds fine. I mean, it sounds good enough. To me, I don't think I'll be replacing it. 1973. Yeah, Deep Purple, Made in Japan. Another one of my favorite bands, and a big reason to show this one is because, to me, this is the, I mean, I know there were lots of live albums before this, but this is the one, to me, that really introduced the two-record set live album that became so popular in the 1970s, and a couple years ago, I did a video on five favorite double live albums from the 1970s, so this would have been one of those. Two-record set. Not that many songs, though. Two-record set, but there's only seven songs spread across four sides. Fantastic live album. And for 1974, Rod Stewart, Play It Again, Rod. Yeah, Sing It Again, Rod. Sing It Again, Rod. This is actually the inner sleeve. Here's the... No, wait. This is the inner sleeve. Here's the cover. You can see it's shaped like a whiskey tumbler, I guess is what that would be called. And this goes inside it. We get some cool pictures of Rod DeMod. And then the credits are on the inside of it. So, yeah. So this is his first greatest hits album. I mean, just listen to the songs on here. Reason to Believe, You Wear It Well, Mandolin Wind, Country Comfort, Maggie May, Handbags and Glad Rags. That's the first side. Side 2, Street Fighting Man, Twisting the Night Away, Los Paraguayos, I Know I'm Losing You, Pinball Wizard, and Gasoline Alley. That version of Pinball Wizard, that is, it's not good. And the only reason they stuck it on here was because it was like a single, maybe, that he had released when his Greatest Hits album was coming out. So it's definitely not one of his greatest hits. They stuck that one on there. But other than that, every song is absolutely fantastic. 1975. And when I got to 1975, a little bit of a problem there. I just don't have that many records from 1975. And the ones I have, I like them all. I mean, they're all good, you know, but there's nothing I think is that outstanding. I chose Aerosmith, Toys in the Attic, because this is one that I did like a lot when it came out. I still like it, I guess. I listened to it last night, though, and it really hasn't stood the test of time too well. And, yeah, but 75, you know, there was like maybe like a three-man army from 75. There were several others I could have picked, which would have all been basically about like this one. Good, you know, solid albums. So we'll see what happens from in the next 15 years, 76 to 90. I don't think I'm going to... I think 75 might end up being probably my weakest year, though. So that's it. There's one record for each year of my life. Thanks very much for the idea. Gatefold 33, Dale. And yeah, so if anybody else wants to jump in on this thread, it'd be interesting to see what records you come up with for each year of your life. And yeah, let me know what you think about these choices. So yeah, that's it. I hope everybody's having a happy holiday season so far. Yeah, thanks very much for watching.